A very warm welcome to Durham Cathedral, the shrine of St. Cuthbert, on this feast of St. Francis of Assisi. These few words are by way of introduction to our quiet day, which is taking place online today in very many various ways. We hope that you'll be able to tap into it. And any bits that you miss, don't worry, because you'll be able to catch up on them later on, either on our Facebook page or on our website. Just a little bit of introduction to St. Francis of Assisi as we begin. St. Francis is one of the most well-known saints. I'm sure that many of you will have heard of him and will know something about his life and his witness and his legacy. Francis grew up near Assisi, the son of a very wealthy cloth merchant. He enjoyed life. He was a bit of a party animal, I think, from what we've gathered, and was very keen on socialising, spending time with his friends. Various things happened to him in his young life that made him consider the depth of his engagement with God. At one point he was sent off to war, at another point he became rather seriously ill. All of these made him ponder what his life and vocation was all about, and he decided to embrace poverty, Lady Poverty, as he called her. Poverty for Francis meant stripping away everything that separated him from God or distracted him from God, and getting back very simply to a sense of being at one with God's creation, being part of God's creation, equal to the sun and the moon, equal to the animals that we see around us, equal to even the seemingly least of God's people. So St. Francis had a huge concern for the poor and for the marginalised. He embraced the lepers of his day, a symbol of embracing those that others fear to touch or to go near. Francis felt a call and heard a call from God to rebuild his church at the chapel of San Damiano, just again on the outskirts of Assisi. He took this literally, originally, and tried to rebuild it with his own bare hands, but later he came to understand this call was to rebuild the church in the wider sense, to help call the church of his day back to the simplicity of its calling, to journey simply and humbly and with joy. St. Francis also had a huge concern for creation and for helping people to connect with creation. And so it's very fitting that today, as we begin to think about the life of St. Francis on this his feast day, we are also pondering what it means for us to be part of God's creation and to have a call to care for that creation wisely. We are part of it, and often we don't care for it as well as we should have done, something that is borne witness to by the COP26 conference in Glasgow taking place very shortly. So we'll be pondering what it means to work towards climate justice as we journey through this time. The programme for today is framed in prayer. So morning prayer takes place as normal at 8:30. There's midday prayer at 12 o'clock. There's evensong at 5:30, and there is Compline this evening at 8:45. There's also a Zoom discussion group at 7:30 this evening for members of the community of prayer. And there's two reflections that will frame our day too. At 10 o'clock this morning, there'll be a reflection on St. Francis and creation, and this will be given by Brother Clark within the Society of St. Francis. He's the guardian of Hillfield Friary in Dorset, and he'll be telling us something about St. Francis's life and calling. And then at 2:30 this afternoon, we will have our second reflection on the Church in Theology and Climate Crisis. And that will be given by Catherine Walton, who is a joint environmental chaplain here in the Diocese of Durham. As we prepare to enter into this quiet day, it seems fitting perhaps just to share some words as we end from the Canticle of the Creatures, something I'd encourage you to look up and to ponder today during this quiet day as food for thought. It's written by St. Francis, and it sets the themes for our time together very well indeed. I'm going to end with just the final verse, because there's quite a few verses of it, and it is set to music.
Most High,
omnipotent, good Lord, to thee be ceaseless praise outpoured, and blessing without measure. Let creatures all give thanks to thee, and serve in great humility. We look forward to journeying with you during this quiet day. Every blessing as you pray, as you ponder, as you reflect alone, as you reflect with God, and as you reflect with others. We look forward to seeing you at morning prayer at 8:30.